What's up, guys? Welcome back to Clever TV. I'm Joslyn Davis in the studio with my partner in crime, as usual, Dana Ward.
Hello.
And we are super excited to have joining us on the eve of the series finale of 1TL.
Wow.
It's Shantel VanSanten.
Hi, guys.
Can you believe it? This is the eve of the series finale.
I can't at all believe that that the show's ending. It really actually hit me last night when I started going through my Twitter feed, which I've kind of avoided for the last week, and I couldn't figure out why. Like, I'll go tweet something, but I haven't been reading my feed because I started bawling last night. People are like, you know, please help us tweet, like, goodnight, One Tree Hill, or all of these, like, I can't believe, like, thank you for giving us Quinn, thank you for all your, and I'm just like, it was overwhelming. It's like all these feelings of bittersweetness coming back up again.
Oh my gosh. Well, it really is crazy that it is finally the end. I'm sure you've had some time to kind of think back to maybe some of your favorite memories of the show. Please share.
I know, it's so funny because because everybody asks me that, and I think, I don't know how like Joy and Sophia and James do it because they have 9 years of memories.
It's crazy. Yeah.
But, you know, I have three, and I feel like it's kind of felt like a lifetime. You know, some of the best memories for me were when we got to dress up in crazy costumes. Me and Joy and Sophia got to be superheroes. We were like Shutterbug, Baby Mama, and Bedazzle. And it was
nice.
Such like an outrageous episode and like off the wall and just comedic and not normal for the One Tree Hill audience. It wasn't dramatic. And it was just so much fun to do something like that. And, you know, then there's episodes, you know, this season when we had our proposal episode last week that felt like,
my heart.
Yeah, I felt like I just waited like 3 years for that moment and it felt perfect. It felt like in real life how it should feel. It was just the right moment. You know what I mean? Like, I couldn't have, you know, sometimes you'll get storylines and you're like, really already? Or like, wow, I don't know about this. And it, you know, when I read it, I was totally surprised by it and so excited for our characters.
So tomorrow with the series finale upon us, obviously you already know what's happened, but we've heard inklings that there's going to be a hint of the wedding. What do you have to say about that? Because we know that this show's notorious for like flash forwards and that kind of thing.
I don't think I ever wear a white dress, but you never know.
Maybe
I wear a bikini. Just kidding. That'd be disgusting. Maybe I'm like Pam Anderson. You know, I'm really happy with the way the finale is. The finale isn't just like a day. You know, it kind of takes place over a certain period of time, and I feel like it gives the audience more closure. I know for me, I had closure. And you know, you're never gonna get to know our whole life story in the episode. It's not as though we can, you know, show us as 80 rocking on the porch and this is where our lives, you know, ended up. But I think that it's gonna leave people with peace moving forward and knowing that, you know, we're all still going to be existing in Tree Hill and having our lives. But I think it'll leave everybody really at peace. And Mark has a really great way, I always say, of writing epic, quiet stories. There's stories that like resonate in your heart and you can walk away feeling at peace, and it's not gonna be a big, overly dramatic episode. Everybody's, I feel like, just gonna walk away with total peace and complete like happiness with how the show ended. And then everybody's gonna ask for a movie to be made. We already know.
Yeah, are you
like, so when is the movie gonna be made? I mean, that would be awesome, I think, to have a movie, and Mark's so good at writing, I feel like he could. But who knows?
I love that the girls on your cast, from what it sounds like, you know, really get along so well. Such a great example for girls out there. And also, we're both involved with a great organization called Team True Beauty, which you're the spokesperson for. Why did you decide to jump on board? Because there's so many options out there for celebrities.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. It happened really, I guess you could say, like, organically. I've done things with different charities like Rally for Kids with Cancer and Planet Hope, and this one just kind of happened. I did an interview with Miriam, who's on the board with Team True Beauty as well, and she just asked me to talk about what True Beauty meant to me, and it kind of evolved into this interview of me telling, you know, my struggles with weight and eating disorders, and then next thing I know, I had kind of already stepped onto this platform, and girls were looking up to me and asking me for advice, and it kind of just evolved naturally, and I couldn't be more grateful for that. I don't really know how it happened. You know, like one day I was doing an interview, and the next day they asked me to be the ambassador, and I'm writing for the newsletter, and which is something I've always wanted to write. And so it's been really great to discover that passion Through something I feel even more passionate about. And
well,
and
you're
to help
really
grow.
Good at it because I've seen you speak twice, and I'm like, this is mini Oprah.
I'm literally, wow. I'm so nervous. I get like crazy nervous. Like the first time I had to speak for our 1 year anniversary, I know like threw up the whole day before. I was like shaking.
Well,
I was,
you're
like,
a good actress.
I was so
girl.
Nervous. I'm like shaking. It's so funny. It's different when you stand up and you read a script as a character and you can psych yourself out, but it's different when like I stand up as myself and I speak mm-hmm. out on something I believe in and something I wrote and I put myself out there. But I think that's what it takes to show girls that that's what they have to do. You know, they have mm-hmm. to stand up for their lives and tell their stories. That way other people can feel inspired and we can work to make a change.
Well, thanks for coming by,
Shantel. Thank you for having me.
This has been so fun. And you guys, don't forget to mark those calendars, set those timers, because tomorrow night is the series finale of One Tree Hill. And of course, we'll have an info section link below for you guys to get all the 411 on Team True Beauty as well. I'm Joslyn Davis with Dana Ward and Shantel VanSanten, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks, guys.